When you first glance at the front of a circuit breaker, it can look like someone's written their life story on the front of it. There's so much writing and so many symbols on there, you could get the impression that it's giving you directions to some buried treasure. And in a way, it is, the prize being a safe electrical installation. So let's crack the code. The first thing you'll see is the branding of the manufacturer. In this case, it's BG, which is short for British General, who are part of the Luceco group and supporting this video. If you're watching this on any of our social media platforms, then click the link to watch it as part of our free training package. You'll get a certificate and it'll count towards your annual CPD requirement. If you're already watching it as part of that package, give yourself a pat on the back. Let's get into the rest of the information. Moving our way down the breaker, you'll see there's a code on the left here. It's CUMB50. This is the manufacturer's product code for this specific device. It helps you during installation to make sure it's the correct breaker that's been specified for that job. And if you're doing maintenance, fault finding, or extending an existing installation, it can help you find the manufacturer's information for the device. So a quick internet search for CUMB50 brings up a range of places you can buy it from and the webpage from BG with lots more information on the breaker. To the right of this, there's a marking that shows 230/400 volts, which are the voltages that the breaker can operate with. 230 volts would be if it's used in a single phase circuit and 400 volts if it's used for a three phase circuit. Following this is the little symbol which represents a sine wave and indicates that this breaker is designed for an AC circuit. Moving down a line, we come to this little rectangle, which is actually a cutaway window and changes colour depending on the position of the switch. When the window is green, it indicates that the circuit breaker is in the off position, and when it's red, that means the breaker is in the on position. Next to this is the symbol B50. You'll remember this was embedded in the product code, and the two parts of this symbol tell us something about the breaker. First of all, the letter tells us the type of device this is. Type in this context basically means how quickly the device will operate or trip when a certain amount of current passes through it. There are five different types of MCB. The three more common ones are B, C, and D. You'll sometimes hear people say that these are used in domestic, commercial, and industrial settings. This is incorrect. While it's unusual to see a type C or D in a domestic setting, it's not unheard of. The key difference between them is the amount of current it takes to get them to trip quickly in the event of a short circuit where a line and neutral or line and line touch each other, and an earth fault of negligible impedance, which is basically where a line and earth conductor touch each other. We discussed those faults in some detail in a previous video in this series. Deciding which of these you install boils down to the type of load you're supplying. Loads like motors and certain types of lighting draw a large amount of current for a brief period. When first turned on, the B type sees this as a fault and will disconnect the circuit even though there's not a fault. As the C and D type are less sensitive to this large but very brief current, they are less likely to trip when protecting a circuit feeding this kind of load. There's guidance given in table 7.2.72 as to the kinds of load each circuit breaker type will protect. So type C's are for small motors, fluorescent lighting, we should mention LED lighting. Also has quite large but incredibly brief inrush currents, and most manufacturers will tell you the maximum number of LED fittings that should be connected to each type of breaker. D types are for highly inductive loads with large inrush currents, such as X-ray machines, large transformers, and welding machines. Loads you might be surprised to find in someone's home, but who are we to judge? The numerical part of this code, the 50, is the nominal rating of the circuit breaker. Again, people will tell you that this is the amount of current that will trip the device. The truth is a little more nuanced than that. It's actually the amount of current that the device will allow to pass through it without tripping. So in theory, 50 amps could pass through this device for all time and it wouldn't ever trip. In fact, if we look at this graph, it shows us that it would take about 70 amps passing through it to make it trip, and even then it would take 10,000 seconds for it to happen. That's about 2 hours and 45 minutes. For more information on the nominal ratings of breakers and selecting the correct device, check out the free training package we made on the subject of electrical design. Moving on to the next line down, we've got the code IEC/EN60898. This is a product standard that circuit breakers must comply with in order to have the code printed on it. This code is used for breakers that are intended for use by uninstructed persons in low humidity and pollution environments. There is another standard for circuit breakers, IEC/EN60947, which we'll cover in another video. To the right of these last two codes, there's a diagram, and this shows us what's going on inside the circuit breaker. First of all, there's a symbol that shows us when the switch is in the up position, it's on, and when it's in the down position, it's off. Then the symbol next to it gives you quite a bit of information about the device. Moving from the top to the bottom, the first thing you come across is an X. This indicates that the device can make and break under full fault capacity. In other words, it can safely disconnect a circuit under fault without blowing out of the consumer unit. Then there's a horizontal dash. This shows that the breaker can be isolated in the off position, so you can lock it off using one of several clever widgets to stop someone powering the circuit back up if you're working on it. Then there's this diagonal line which represents the switching mechanism inside here, followed by a strange dual symbol. This is actually a curved line and a square combined into one. The square represents the magnetic device inside here that protects against high current faults and reacts very quickly. And the curved line represents the thermal mechanism that protects against too many loads being connected to each other. In the next video in this series, we're going to take this apart and have a look inside at these two components. Then, along the bottom, there's a symbol that says UKCA. This stands for UK Conformity Assessed and is a mark to indicate that a product conforms with relevant standards and so can be sold in the UK. It basically acts as an alternative to the CE or European conformity mark that we'll find on the side of the breaker, which similarly allows the device to be sold in the European Union. Next to this is this S inside a circle symbol, which represents Semko, the former Swedish Standardization Office, who are now part of Intertek LTD, a standards and conformity organisation. Finally, on the front, there's a box with 6,000 in it. This is the ultimate braking capacity of the circuit breaker. It's often shortened to ICN, and it indicates the maximum amount of current that it can break safely in the event of a fault without welding itself shut in the process. Below this is a 3 in a box. So what does this indicate? Well, rather than being a numerical value of a quality of the MCB, it refers to the energy class of the device. This is an indication of how much energy a circuit breaker will allow to pass through itself under fault conditions. The actual value of this let-through energy varies depending on the nominal rating of the MCB and is helpful for electrical designers when it comes to ensuring correct selectivity of circuits. So there we go, that's all the information you'll find on the front of one of these MCBs. If you're watching on our training platform, then answer the multiple choice questions that follow and move on to the next video. If you're watching on one of our social media channels, then click the link to move over to the free training package and get yourself a certificate, or you can watch the same video in the series right here to find out exactly what is going on inside a circuit breaker and how it protects against overcurrent. All that remains in this video is to say, thank you very much for watching.